We also had a correction on the March 30th meeting minutes. Are there any additions or corrections on the March 30th commissioner meeting minutes? And I actually have that backwards. The 23rd is the one that was amended. March 30th, we're fine. So March 30th, no changes. The minutes will stand approved as presented at this time. I'll recognize my executive assistant, Anne-Marie Grill, with the public comment policy.
Thank you, Commissioner Leinbach. Public comment will be accepted in person and through the Q&A function. Please include your first name, last name, and municipality for all comments. Any comments without name and municipality will not be considered. Each citizen can submit one comment. Comment length is dictated by limitations of the platform being used, Teams Q&A, Facebook, and YouTube. In-person comments will be accepted first, followed by comments submitted virtually. The meeting comment period is limited to a total of 30 minutes, including both in-person and virtual comments. This time period may be extended at the discretion of the board. Please be concise. Comments that are germane to county business will be read during the meeting and should not be considered to be interactive dialogue with the commissioners. The county solicitor shall be the final arbiter of whether a comment is germane and should be read. Any commissioner response to public comment will be done at the discretion of the commissioners.
Thank you very much. There's no public comment in person on agenda items, and there is no public comment online at this time. You might notice the image that we're showing is the famous Reading Fight and Phil's First Energy Stadium sign. It's been referenced numerous times because every morning when Ron Seaman comes into work, he sees the sign, and that sign tells him two things: how many days to opening day and how many days to his retirement, which is April the 11th. If you also notice, the sign says opening day is April 11th, 4 days until opening day and Ron's retirement. Yes, it does.
Wait for it, Ron.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
So, Anne-Marie Grill gets credit for this on her own. I don't think she asked anybody's permission. She goes with the old philosophy of the worst they could say is no. So she called Scott Hunsinger several weeks ago and said, Scott, I want you to know about Ron Seaman. He's been talking about your sign. He goes past it every day. Would you mind adding his name the last week before opening day? And so Scott Hunsinger went ahead and did that, and we thought it was appropriate to show it this morning. Anne-Marie actually drove over there this morning so that the 4 days is accurate. So great work. Well, do you have another link up there yet? If he doesn't, it doesn't matter. Today is Ron's last official commissioner's meeting as the COO and as an small gap in between, but Ron's touched a lot of lives and a lot of people. And I'd like to start the recognition. The commissioners have something we'd like to present to you. Don't worry, it's not a gold watch. and the taxpayers didn't buy it. So if the commissioners want to come up with me, and Kevin, if you could join us as well. You can stand up.
Yeah, fish, I've been
You didn't practice this, so.
Send that back down there. This says Ronald R. Seaman, in recognition of your commitment and dedication to the county of Berks. I'm gonna give you, so at least don't squeeze hard.
There you go.
Oh, my.
These people are absolutely incredible. Last Monday, they shocked me beyond belief by tricking me into going to the Ag Center to look over construction plans for the renovations that are taking place here, only to walk into an auditorium filled with about 70 people and a delightful spread of food prepared by Christine Sadler and baked goods. And now this today and the sign, it's like, I don't know what to say. It's over the top. I can't thank commissioners present and past for the opportunity to be here and do what I've done. It's been a real pleasure. I don't know where 30 years went to. It's like a blink of an eye. I am very, very, very much going to miss the workforce and the people I've been privileged to be with during this period of time. I am looking forward to trying new and different things, but I'm gonna miss this place, and I will be in touch with a lot of individuals because I can't just walk away. Thank you so much for everything.
I'm gonna open the floor up, including some of our folks that may be online, to give people an opportunity to make any comments, all positive, nothing nasty. We will cut you off if there's anything inappropriate, but we'll open the mic for anyone that would like to share their thoughts and comments. Go ahead.
Something very short.
Sure.
So this is just very short and sweet, and it's a quote by Ellen Montgomery. Ron, so take this with you. I don't know what lies around the bend, but I'm going to believe the best does. So good luck going around that bend and enjoy every moment.
Hey, Ron.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Ron?
No, I've said it many times, Ron, so I just want to say best wishes in your retirement. Enjoy this next phase in your life. Make sure you spend time with your family and friends, and do that Route 66 trip you've been talking about. So enjoy.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
I'm going to save my comments for the end. Kevin.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. I have one regret that I wasn't here. Yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
I have one regret that I wasn't here for Ron's first tenure with the county, and had spent that kind of time with him. But the last 6.5+ years, it's been an honor and a privilege, Ron, to serve with you, not just here, but on the BARTA board and ultimately the South Central Transit Authority board. And you've been a mentor to me and a colleague and most of all, a friend. Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin. I know this county is going to be in good hands with you and Larry at the helm. Thank you.
And Jesse Blauser and Britt Finkowski. I just thought I'd add that. Other comments? Sandy Graffius.
For those of you that don't know,
you're
Ron
muted.
Is a...
Yeah, maybe turn the volume up.
Okay, can you hear me now?
He's not muted.
Nah, it doesn't show that you're muted.
Okay, I'll tell you what, take somebody else. I'll go out and come back. I'll go out and come back in.
We can't hear you. So what you might want to do, and we'll hold for you, log out, log back in. That may help.
Larry had some comments.
Larry, go ahead.
Thank you, commissioners. I'll go back even a little further to the days when I was a young staffer working for the late Paul Angstad, who was the state representative. And anytime you needed to come into the courthouse, the person to see was Ron Seaman. And I remember coming in here when you were still over on the third floor of the courthouse and this building didn't even exist. And you were kind to me then, and I always appreciated it because I didn't know my rear end from a hole in the ground, and it was the truth. And you helped then, and I think you always set a good example in the roles that you had. Of course, I got elected in 95 and worked with you then, and now have the opportunity to have had the opportunity to learn from you and have you, as Kevin said, as a mentor. You know, Kevin has referred to you as Mr. Miyagi. Mine has been Master Yoda. What I think really amazes me, and why I do think you have superpowers, is I don't know how you managed to keep all the balls in the air the way you did. We are racing around like crazy. There's so much to do. And you did it with style, and you did it with class, and you did it with grace, and all the while got things done. So thank you. I wish you a long, healthy, happy retirement, and I look forward to seeing you playing your bagpipes in the first parade.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you. I asked, do we have the audio fixed?
I'm back on.
Okay, well, we're going to show a video here quick. Go ahead and show the clip. This is from Facebook. There's no sound, though. You have to choose sound, but that's okay. It's scarier without sound. Who was that? Photobomb is what that was. Okay.
No, that's scary.
So this shows Kevin's training started at a Christmas party. You got to learn. So
let's see,
hopefully try Sandy, see if we have your audio.
Okay, can you hear me now?
No, we don't, but Malcolm Towns can hear her. So there's something going on in the room here.
Okay, well, I'll just tell you that for all of you that are watching.
Yep, can't hear a word.
Ron is a
singer. We're going to have to get that resolved. If IS can jump on that, we'll make sure there's time a little bit later on.
That's fine.
For comment, I'm going to close this segment. I heard a poem many, many years ago, and I've shared it, I know, at least once in honor of a man that had a lot of influence in my life, a man that lived up in the Scranton area. And I want to share this because it talks, I think, about how you've touched the lives of people throughout your years here at the county. And don't be offended how it starts out. It's called The Bridge Builder. It's by Will Allen Dromagul. An old man going a lone highway came at the evening cold and gray to a chasm vast, deep, and wide, through which was flowing a sullen tide. The old man crossed in the twilight dim. The sullen stream had no fear for him, but he turned when safe on the other side and built a bridge to span the tide. Old man, said a fellow pilgrim near, you're wasting your strength with building here. Your journey will end with the ending day. You never again will pass this way. You've crossed the chasm deep and wide. Why build this bridge at evening tide? The builder lifted his old gray head. Good friend, in the path I've come, he said, there followed after me today a youth whose feet must pass this way. This chasm that has been as naught to me, to that fair-haired youth may a pitfall be. He too must cross in the twilight dim. Good friend, I'm building this bridge for him.
Yeah.
That picture was at my son's wedding with my grandson, Dawson. Two guys that mean the world to me. I'll let Sandy see if she can say, but I'd like to just say one thing then.
Yep, try it, Sandy.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, we can.
Good. Go ahead, Ron, say your thing.
There's no way I can ever, ever pay back everyone for the kindnesses that they've shown to me through the years, and last week and today. But I want it to be known that whatever I may have accomplished or left undone was not solely because of me. It was because of the wonderful people this county has in important places. It's all a team effort. And I really don't want anyone to look at a list of accomplishments or failures. I just want to be remembered by two simple words, and that's, he tried. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll chime in now. For those of you that don't know, Ron is a singer, and he sings with a chorus. And every now and then, he and I would be in the elevator or some hallway, and something would happen that would make us break into song. And we would stand there and sing together, and the people around us would look at us like we weren't quite right, but we knew we weren't, so it was okay. The next thing, I want to do a poem for Ron, because this is so typical of him. There are two kinds of people on earth today. Just two kinds, no more, I say. Not the rich and the poor, for to know a man's wealth, you must first know the state of his conscience and health. Not the happy and sad, for life's passing years, each has his laughter and each has his tears. No, the two kinds of people on earth, I mean, are the people who lift and the people who lean. And Ron is a lifter.
Thank you, Sandy.
Thank you so much.
Since we have the issues resolved, is there anyone else either in person or online that would like to make a comment? Okay. Thank you, Ron. We'll move on with our agenda. Item one, authorizing under that budget department, adopt a resolution authorizing 2023 transfers in the amount of $815,712 and 2023 appropriations in the amount of $135,872 per listing dated March 31st of 2023. There are three items listed under human resources. Item one, authorize the appointment of Dawn Cuck to senior financial analyst in budget and finance. Item two, authorize the promotion of Marcia Muth from voter registrar 2 to administrative assistant in election services. And item three, authorize the promotion of Jeffrey Reichert from aging assessor 3 area agency on aging to elections operations system manager in the elections office. We have one item listed under Commissioner Rivera. Adopt a resolution amending a prior resolution to reflect the reappointment of Michael Toledo, Blandon, Pennsylvania, to the Schuylkill River Passenger Rail Authority Technical Committee for a 2-year term expiring on July 30th of 2025. There are several items listed under the commissioners. Item A, adopt a resolution authorizing the execution of the Pennsylvania Emergency Management Agency Hazardous Material Emergency Response Preparedness Report for reporting year 2022. Item B, adopt a resolution authorizing Kevin S. Barnhart, Chief Operations Officer, to execute a termination of grant agreement terminating the grant dated October 3rd, 2022 to the Schuylkill River Greenways in the amount of $51,564, no portion of which has been dispersed, which grant was made in partial match of the Pennsylvania Department of Conservation and Natural Resources for construction of a new section of the Schuylkill River Trail between Kelly's Lock and Pioneer Grove along River Road in Muhlenberg Township. Item C, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the Automobile Theft Motor Vehicle Insurance Fraud Intergovernmental Agreement between the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, Pennsylvania State Police, and Berks County for participation in the Municipal Automobile Theft Motor Vehicle Insurance Fraud Task Force Program for fiscal years 23 and 24. Item D, adopt a resolution authorizing the appointment of Lucine E. Sahelnik, Commissioner, Reading, PA, to the Foundation for the Reading Public Museum Board of Directors, replacing Kevin S. Barnhart for a term expiring December 31st of 2023. Item E, adopt a resolution authorizing Brian Gottschall, Director of Berks County Emergency Services, to apply for fiscal year 2023 Emergency Management Planning Grant funding in the amount of $150,806.66. The EMPG grant supports a 50% portion of the salaries and benefits of the emergency coordinator, planner, and eligible training. Item F, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the 2022 Senior Judge Reimbursable Cost Grant from the Administrative Office of Pennsylvania Courts in the reimbursement request amount of $79,280 to offset the cost of senior judges and their staff. Item G, adopt a resolution authorizing the execution of the Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency grant application for the Forensic Science Combating Opioids fiscal year 22-23 subgrant within the District Attorney's Office totaling $90,925. The funds will be used for training, certification, and equipment for the forensic personnel to combat the opioid and synthetic drug crisis. H, adopt a resolution authorizing Christine M. Sadler, solicitor, to execute the Susquehanna Accounting and Consulting Solutions, Inc. letter of agreement to provide consulting services to the County of Berks. Item I, adopt a resolution announcing at this time, due to the current economic uncertainties and the need to reserve available American Rescue funds for county projects, there shall be no further allocation of American Rescue funds for any non-county request. Item two, a motion to authorize execution of contract agreements and amendments as set forth on the contract agenda listing dated April the 3rd of 2023. There are a total of 9 contracts. There are 3 with the Area Agency on Aging. There's 1 with Adult Probation. There's 1 with Election Services, 1 with Human Resources, 1 with the Berks County Jail, 1 with Juvenile Probation, and 1 with Mental Health and Developmental Disabilities. Item 3, a motion to authorize execution of the payments and electronic transfers is set forth on the Controller's Office voucher listing dated April the 6th of 2023. Item 4, a motion to authorize execution of employee payroll disbursements dated April the 11th of 2023. Item 5, motion to authorize execution of tax collector payroll payments dated April the 14th of 2023.
Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
Second.
The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Yes.
Yes, thank you. Regarding resolution 148, with respect, I support this resolution with appreciation to our fiduciary responsibility to the county and to our constituents. However, I do have a suggestion to my fellow board members, if you would entertain for consideration. We're currently successfully engaged in 49 projects that are in the process of bringing transformational impact to our community. These legacy projects to nonprofits, other municipalities, and businesses will have long-term effect. By the end of this month, I believe that our Imagine Berks team will have updates to these funds that have been committed. I do not want to pass this resolution in haste or neglect the fact that based on the reporting that will come, there may be some funds that have not been depleted or some projects that may have changed that maybe become ineligible or even that some funds are no longer needed and could be returned to the county. The potential of the sum of the committed funds not spent is what actually concerns me. Is there a willingness of the board to consider the potential of reinvestment of any of these funds committed but not used from the 49 projects in the future? Perhaps from the due diligence of initial project reviews and awards, which is currently happening. There may now be some funds and some projects that have scored very, very highly in the past in the first round, but were not shovel ready at the time or did not have complete funding models or support from necessary stakeholders. So I ask the board to consider the future use of these funds that have already been committed to continue to bolster economic recovery and development for Berks County. Thank you.
Thoughts?
And something I would definitely consider in speaking with Kevin, I think that's still quite a few months down the road yet. So at that point, once we have those numbers, it would be something I would be willing to look at. In my point of view, it would be separate from resolution 148.2023I. But yes, I would be willing to entertain it once we know and have a better idea of what that would look like.
And I appreciate the concern as well. I have raised this issue several times. I think we have a significant obligation in light of the continued economic certainties to protect the balance of what we have. If dollars become available in the future, we can look at that. But right now, my focus is making sure that we are making a strong fiscal decision in the interest of the county. So, and just so we keep in mind on the rules on the timing, and I know you know this because we've gone over it, but money for ARP has to be allocated no later than the end of 2024. So you might think, well, why are we rushing now? If that money is allocated at the last minute and then not utilized, it can be clawed back by the federal government. We don't want that to happen. We want to make sure that the projects that are already funded actually happen. That's why they have until, I believe, the end of the year to spend those funds. And there are a handful that have indicated they need an extension. And I think we're looking at some extensions into early 2024, but not into the latter part, or I think even into the latter half of 2024. So as those issues come up, I'm willing to look at those on a case-by-case basis. But I think there's a need to make a declaratory statement. This is where we are. As recently as this week, I was contacted by another nonprofit in the area, a legitimate, good nonprofit that is looking for American Rescue dollars. Probably within the last month, I've heard from 4 to 5 different nonprofits that want money. And I think we have an obligation to say there is no money at this time. And if you look at the resolution, that's literally what it says. Adopt a resolution announcing at this time, due to the current economic uncertainties and that we're reserving. So that's where I am as well. Okay? Any other discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. We'll move now to reports of our treasurer and controller, and we'll start with Socrates Georgiadis, our acting county treasurer.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We have an opening balance of $208,394,317.24. We have a balance to clear of $3,077,591.67, leaving us with a balance of $205,316,725.57. And Mr. Chairman, I would be remiss if I didn't say that I'm proud to have been Ron Seaman's friend since 1980. I remember almost the day that we met. And Ron, good luck to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sock, and keep on doing the good work.
Sandy Graffius, our county controller, with the controller's report.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Okay, good. Accounts payable, $11,054,537.61. As you mentioned, we have a payroll of $4,749,438.83. We had a tax collector payroll of $103,467.98 for a grand total. And Sock, I'm going to take this right out of your bank account. $15,907,444.42. The end.
Hopefully that's not in Sock's bank account. That would be a problem. just saying, okay? I'm going to, in light of what today is, turn to Ron Seaman for your last Chief Operations Officer report. Put you on the spot.
Yeah, you kind of have, because I really don't have anything to report other than what has already been said. I do have a few words I'd like to offer later on in conjunction with something you're going to be speaking on.
Okay. Anything in Dutch?
Was het wezen? Mijn handelser verzameling moet ook over het on the least part.
I'm looking around auction. Here for someone to translate.
It's our annual Berks County for someone.
That's what
it's
I thought
Monday
you
were... night, Easter Monday.
Okay.
Again, when I first started attending that, I was 16 years old, and we met at Kutztown University in their dining hall, and we had attendance somewhere between 600 and 800 people. Monday night, the last count I had, we have 270, which, given the fact that we had to curtail it for 2 years because of the pandemic, and rebuild, we're quite pleased with that turnout.
Yeah, and for people that don't understand, a versammeling is an annual gathering of people in Berks County who still speak Pennsylvania Dutch. They tend to be non-Mennonite, non-Amish. These are English. And that, from the time they pretty much walk in the door and you open the meeting, you can only speak Pennsylvania Dutch. Now, there's a little humor to that because I grew up around it, and it's amazing how many English words get thrown in here and there. And if you're really following closely, you may not be able to converse, but you can figure out what they're talking about because of the way those words are thrown in. What's interesting, what's different about the Mennonite and Amish, they keep the language alive in a very different way. If you grow up in a Mennonite or Amish home, they only allow Pennsylvania Dutch spoken in the home. So the children, many of the children don't learn English until they go to first grade, where they learn to speak English. And that's even true today, but all the best. Kevin Barnhart, our Chief Operations Officer.
Thank you. We wish to thank the board for helping Bob and his staff, Chief Financial Officer, with a senior financial analyst, very well necessary and needed. And especially voter registrar Marcia Muth, now administrative assistant, and Jeff Riker joining us in election operations and system manager, actually fills out our leadership management roles in election services. We still have vacancies for voter registrars, but it helps to build a team under Ann Norton. So we appreciate that. And under the contract through Election Services with BCTV for multi-year recording, video recording of the election process, the pre-canvassing part. So thank you. We're making great strides in Election Services and very happy with the outcome so far. Thank you.
Great.
And here's Larry.
Larry Medaglia, our Deputy COO.
If I might, Commissioners, just to give you an update on the space allocation study with Beers and Hoffman. We had two of the architects who were leading the team from their firm here with us yesterday and the day before. We have concluded all of the inspection of the downtown campus. The questionnaires for department heads and for the employees have been out and are coming back and being returned. So all of that information is being processed. And Monday, we will start in earnest with the department head interviews, where we'll go out and spend some time with each department, try to get a better sense of what their needs are going forward. And this is a very forward-looking study. We're looking at both needs for the next 5 years and then out to a 10-year look to get a better sense of what the needs will be for our departments, department heads, employees, and the folks who utilize the services that are provided here by county government. So things are moving right along, and we appreciate the support that we've gotten from the board to conduct this survey, which is much needed. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And with that, we'll move to commissioners' reports, and we'll begin with Commissioner Michael Rivera.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. I do have to tell you that, as you know, my grandparents are Pennsylvania Dutch. Mm-hmm. My grandfather was a Mennonite pastor for many, many, many years. But my grandparents never taught their children, our grandchildren, Pennsylvania Dutch because they wanted to be able to speak about them without them understanding.
Yes.
So the Pennsylvania Dutch stopped at my grandparents. My mother knows some words, but not too much. So I'm sorry I couldn't understand and help you out with interpreting what you were saying, Ron. Just a few things on my end. One, this weekend, tomorrow and Saturday is Pennsylvania's third annual Latino Health Summit. And this year it is being held here in Reading at the Doubletree. There will be different workshops and sessions going on all day tomorrow, Friday. And then Saturday from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. is a health and wellness expo, where there will be wellness workshops, fitness activities, healthy food demonstrations, health screenings, dental assessments, and more. And this part of it on Saturday is free and open to everyone. So Saturday morning, if you are available, want to learn more resources, learn about healthy cooking, and get some health-related information, please drop by the Doubletree between 9 and 1 a.m. if you are a healthcare, social services, or public health professional and would want to be part of professional workshops on Friday, you can register for that. More information is available at latinoconnection.org under their events page. Again, that is latinoconnection.org under their events page. Also, want to remind everyone this Tuesday, although we spoke about it, is the opening days for the Fight and Fills, which also coincide with Ron's retirement day. And just recently, Barbara and I have been meeting with different department heads, and they've all had positive things to say about Ron, and, you know, how easy it was to talk with him, how supportive he was, how, you know, if there was a situation that arose and they were all worried about it, Ron would remain calm and say, okay, you know, how can we work through this? What can we do to get through this situation? So they all had positive things to say about Ron and their experience with him and these last years. So I'll be looking to see what they have to say about Kevin and Larry in the next years as well.
No pressure.
Yeah. So again, Ron, congratulations on your retirement. May you have much health to be able to enjoy many, many, many more years. And one last item. This weekend is Easter, and it is Passover, so may everyone have a blessed Easter and a blessed Passover. And in Spanish is que tengan una bendecida Pascua y Pascua Judía. And that reminds me of the song that Ron was taught by none other than Carmen, which says, me voy, me voy, me voy, which means that I'm leaving, I'm leaving, I'm leaving. So, Ron, thank you for everything.
Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Zahelnik.
Yes, thank you. Last week I was not here, and that was because it was my privilege to represent Berks County. We were invited by Governor Shapiro in recognition of the tragic events that occurred in West Reading and at the R.M. Palmer factory. And it was an opportunity to support the call to fund our emergency 911 services. In addition to that, I want to let everybody know that there has been over $300,000 raised at this point by the Berks County Community Foundation and United Way efforts for the West Reading Disaster Recovery Funds. I'm still receiving inquiries by individuals, local and beyond Berks County, to say, how can I help? So that is a great way to be able to help if that's appropriate for you. So just to remind everybody of that. Also, I'm wearing blue today, not because it went with my outfit, but in recognition to acknowledge National Child Abuse Prevention Month. As a mom of a five-year-old, it's important to me to increase awareness to prevent child abuse and neglect, and I want to recognize our Children Youth Services team for the display of art and flags on the second floor, I believe, which again is just a really nice public recognition of awareness for our community. I have been busy in doing some visits to different board meetings and departments. Yesterday, I was able to attend the Parks Board meeting and learn more about their spring programming coming to an end and what the summer and fall holds. So be attuned to that. We have wonderful park systems here. And also the library visits. I was able to attend the Hamburg and Boyertown libraries and learn more about them. And I really appreciate my fellow board members' consideration in my appointment for the Reading Public Museum Board. I look forward to serving with them in the capacity of this next year. And finally, I also just want to acknowledge all of those who are celebrating various religious holidays in our community, not just this week, but for weeks to come. I know I'll be celebrating Orthodox Easter next week, and there are various other celebrations of faith. So if you are celebrating, I wish you blessed acknowledgement of what you celebrate in your faith.
Thank you very much. Today has been a celebration very much of Ron Seaman and all that he has meant to the County of Berks, to this community, not just in a role as a COO or chief clerk or elections director, but as a friend. Unfortunately, earlier this month, we lost a longtime friend of Berks County and former HR director in Hal Baker. I met Hal several times, but Hal was already retired for the second time in his life when I became a commissioner, when Kevin and I were both came into office in 2008. But interestingly enough, Hal Baker spent his career at Lucent Technology, retired, and at either 60 or 61 years of age, came on a short-term stint to work in the HR department in Berks County and ended up staying for quite a while and really made an amazing impact. Before I make some closing comments on another topic, I'd like to open up. I reached out to some folks that worked very closely with Hal, and I don't know what order you want to go, but who's going to, Christine Sadler.
Thank you, Commissioner. I had the privilege of working with Hal from the time I came to the 13th floor. I was here before Hal came back, but being in the DA's office, didn't really have the chance to work with Hal on a regular basis. When I came up in April of 2000, Hal became a tremendous mentor to me. I had the distinct privilege of working with him on a daily basis. He taught me everything I know about contract negotiations. He was a tough cookie, and people will call me tenacious, which it's a badge I wear with pride. I do consider myself tenacious and looking out for the best interest of the county, and Hal was very much the same way in terms of how he conducted union negotiations. He truly made sure the county's interest was always at heart, but in a manner that was always appropriate. You know, he wasn't afraid to call people out when they needed to be called out. He was always did so in a respectful manner. But I think in those days, the county's relationship with the union was a much different situation than it is today. But he was able to garner the respect of the union employees and the business agents to a degree that I have not seen since he left the county of Berks. So what a class act, what a true gentleman. He was a great asset and mentor to many, many people at the county of Berks. And that's something we should continue to strive for, to continue to bring in people that are willing to mentor individuals and share their knowledge and their expertise in a way that truly builds up county employees to a new knowledge level than they previously acquired. Thank you.
Thank you, Christine. Larry?
Thank you, commissioners. I was obviously saddened to read about Hal's passing. Like Christine, when I was elected in 95 and took office in 96 in the registrar's office, one of the things that was ongoing was something called the WMS committee, which was back then our system that was in place for compensation for our employees. And there was a committee and a row officer representative was needed, and they asked if I would do it. And that's how I came to know Hal. And we would meet on a monthly basis. And I think when Hal came here, I don't think he ever envisioned staying. I think he came here because it was an interesting opportunity for community service. And I think what he found was there were so many good people who worked here, and he wanted to be a part of that. But as Christine said, he was a mentor. There are certain people that just naturally fit that bill, and he did. But as also Christine said, he would call you out. And one of the things that the WMS committee morphed into was something called the Position Evaluation and Compensation Committee. And that was about a year-long project where we evaluated every position in county government, and department heads had to come in and essentially justify their staff and where we might be able to look for savings. And one of his favorite words in those meetings was bamboozle, and he loved to throw it out. Don't sit here and think you're going to bamboozle me with your double speak. You know, and he would call it. I said he would call BS if he saw it and he heard it and he did it. And the other thing I remember about Hal was positively, he had this great, deep, booming voice. He would have been a great guy on radio. But he had the greatest laugh in the world. He had this high-pitched cackle of a laugh. And
what did it sound like?
I can't do it. I would hurt myself. But it was hysterical, and he cracked himself up. I mean, he would crack a joke and then he would just start giggling like a kid. And it was wonderful. I loved working with him. He was just as Christine said, he was a prince of a man. And I kept in touch with him over the years after he left county government. And we would cross paths now and again. He lived out in Muhlenberg Township and with his wife, Sandy, and just a gentleman, and he will be missed. He's somebody that I'll always fondly remember. And like Ron, he was somebody that made an impact, and you don't forget people like that. Thank you.
Ron.
Thank you, Commissioner. I couldn't agree with Christine and Larry more. Hal was a true gentleman extraordinaire. He brought a lot of wealth to the table in terms of human resource management, contract administration. He came at a good time. The county never had a county-wide personnel department until I became the first one. And my deputy, Lori Lillis, Judge Lillis's wife, succeeded me, and then Hal succeeded her. So We were still kind of in our infancy with a lot of things and the unionization of the county and so forth. But as was alluded to before, Hal brought a balance to a lot of things that could have easily gone off the tracks. And his work ethic was phenomenal. There's a number of times we'd meet on a Monday morning and discuss certain things. He said, yeah, I came in yesterday morning at 7, spent an hour or two working on a particular project, and I went to church and came back afterwards and spent a few more hours here. And he had a dry wit about him that was just phenomenal. He could come up with some earthy sayings that he blended in with his banter. One that sticks with me forever, and I have to clean it up a little bit, was, man, you give them that, and that'll be like flies on a manure pile. he was just a real pleasure to work with and brought a lot of stability to some chaotic times that we had back then. And it was a real pleasure to learn from him and experience working with someone of his caliber.
Thank you very much. And our sympathies to the Baker family on their loss. As noted, we are going into a holiday weekend. I want to wish all of those that celebrate Easter a very blessed Easter. Those that celebrate Passover, a blessed Passover. And I've worked on this, but I believe it's Pesach Sameach is the Hebrew for a blessed or happy Passover. So take care, everyone. Is there any comment from the row officers? Hearing none, there's no public comment in person. Let's just quick check, and I see no public comment online.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
The meeting stands adjourned.